Attention, attention, please. I'm Pat Stevens. I'm pleased as punch to be here at the Chicago Alternative High School, and we're proud to present some teen issues, which I know very little about. But we do have a wonderful speaker today. She's one of your classmates, and she is coordinator of this whole project, Cabrini Green.
Thank you, Pat. I love her show. Most of y'all know me. You know, my name is Cabrini Green, Harlem Watts Jackson. Thank you, thank you. I'm a Libra. My favorite sport is running. I'm in the 10th grade. I'm 17 years old, and I have two children. My son's name is Kwanzaa Uhuru Razak Jackson, and I have a little girl. Her name is Tamae Tequila Watusi Jackson. Anyway, me and my friends were talking about, you know, our experiences with young men, and I was telling them about me and Andre, you know, because me and Andre was together the first time. He told me, he said, Slim, I'm going to make this real good to you. And then we did it. You know what I'm talking about. And then after it was over, he said, was it good to you? And I said, compared to what? He said, did you have an organism? I said, what, do I look like an amoeba or something like that? Boy, get out of my face. You know, but you know, me and my friends were talking about these experiences, and we decided to start a new group, of which I am the international chairperson, and the group is called Stop in the Name of Love. That stands for Single Teenagers Oppressed by Pregnancy. And we have this assembly to, you know, get y'all to join the group and to also teach you the theme song. And I have some friends with me, they call them Mellow White Boys. They're gonna help me teach you this song. Now, we have all kinds of stop stuff. We got stop t-shirts, we got stop signs, we got stop watches, stop clocks. We got things you can put in the back of your car, go like this. So really, the song is really, really easy, and it's kind of got a Motown beat, and really it's inspired by Diana Ross, because I have arms like hers. Sitting in the back seat, kissing on my neck. He tried to touch my bra, I let him for the heck. We were quickly reaching the point of no return. He said that he could teach me, I didn't want to learn. I told him no.
Girl, what's wrong with you?
I told him no.
Now this is something new.
The teenage Casanova said he was gonna cry. He kicked and screamed and pulled his hair, and then he asked me why. Now you girls know, when you're in a situation with a young man and you're already gone more than half the way and he wants to go all the way, you can't say no without a really good reason, because they have a name for girls like that. They tell all their friends and you could never get a date again. Am I right? Now all you girls about 12 or 13 years old can use the excuse that I use. It's about the future and the future of the future. It works. Just tell them what I told them. I don't want a baby. It will drive me crazy. I'm just too lazy to care for a baby. We do everything when we kiss and play, so there's really no need to go all the way. I'm not gonna buy a spermicide, a diaphragm and foam, a contraceptive. If they don't work, then I'm a jerk. I told him no, 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 no. I told him no. Allowance on the pill. It jumbles up my hormones and it makes me ill. I told him no, no. I told him no, no, no. There's no guarantee against pregnancy. Hey, I'm a product of an IUD. Say, girls, when accidents happen, the mistake will live with you. So if you love him, don't make him beg. Just don't get little sperm near your little egg. Or tell him no.